Welcome to Delta 12. My name is Michael, and in this video, I will show you a simple and automatic way to change scenes in Godot Engine using an Area 2D node. First, I would like to say that my projects were made with the help of tutorials on the Heartbeast channel, so of course, I highly recommend that you follow the Heartbeast channel and finish all the action RPG tutorials. By the way, Benjamin, good morning, afternoon, or evening. Hello from Brazil in 2021. My name is Michael, and thank you very much for your tutorials. You're the best, bro. So let's go. First, let's open the central scene, and then let me explain what we are going to do. A very simple way to change scenes in Godot is to use an Area 2D in the Map and Try to detect when the player enters that specific area and then execute the code that we need. Basically, an Area 2D is an area capable of detecting objects that have a collision, like our player, and then emit a signal when that object enters or exits. So, we can use that signal to execute our code. Okay, so let's right-click on level 1 and add a child node. So let's create an Area 2D. Let's click on Area 2D and add a collision shape 2D. So in shape, let's select a rectangular shape. Let's click on Area 2D and click on this icon to ensure that we are going to move both Area 2D and collision shape 2D. And so let's click here to show the grid. Now we can drag Area 2D to the Map and Try, and then clicking on Collision Shape, we can adjust the size. Let's click again on the area, and in the Collision tab, first let's uncheck these two boxes. So we need to check which layer our player is on. Since it is on layer 2, then we have to mark the collision mask 2 of our Area 2D so that it detects only the player. Now let's rename Area 2D to Entrance and Edge Script. Click again on the entrance, and on the node tab, we will connect a body entered signal. We can delete all that part. And we will use the getTree change scene command and pass the central scene path. Let's resolve these two errors. The first one just put an underscore, and the second one just ignore it, and this message will be generated. Now we can test our game. And no right, we can move from the level 1 scene to central. Now we can repeat the same process in the central scene to send the player to the level 1. For now, let's create a new script and call it entrance1. And then we can repeat the same code, just changing the path to level 1. Let's run the game. And okay, everything is working as it should.
Okay, now you know how to change scenes, but using a different script for each entry would be a lot of work. So what we can do is share the same script with all entrances and use the area2D name as a reference for our code, renaming each area2D with the name of the map we want to send our player.
Let's go back to the level 1, right click on the entrance, and then we will select save branch as scene and save. Now let's open the entrance.gd script and manipulate the code string to use the area name and add .tsen. Let's open the entrance scene in the editor, and on the transform tab we will reset its position to 0. Let's save with Ctrl+S, and as you can see, this change has affected level 1, so let's fix the entrance. Now let's go back to the central, and we can delete this entrance, and we will also delete the entrance1.gd script. Okay, right click in central, and we're going to instance child scene, and then we are going to open up the entrance.tcn scene and place it. So let's go back to level 1 and rename entrance to central. And now let's go back to the central scene and rename the entrance to level 1. We can test our game. Okay, now we can change scenes automatically using a single script. All we need to do is instantiate an entrance scene and rename it with the level name the player must be sent.
Now something you might have noticed is that when we change scenes, our player appears in the middle of the map. So to make it appear in the correct position, we are going to use the position2d node. But before that, let me explain something important. When we change scenes in Godot using the change scene code, as soon as the new scene is loaded, the previous scene is closed. So, to save any kind of important information, we need to create an autoload scene. Using an autoloaded scene, when the player enters area2D, it will save its own name, and then, when the new scene is loaded, it will use the saved name to send the player to the correct position.
So first let's add a position to the node to level 1. And position it where we want to the player to appear. And then let's change its name to Central Pulse. Now we can go back to Central and add level 1 pulse. Okay, now we can create our autoload scene, which I will call global. And then we can add a script and declare the variable from level. This variable will save the name of the area 2D that will serve as a reference to change the scene and position the player in the correct position 2D. Let's save the global scene. And then let's open the project settings menu. And in the autoload tab, we will load our global scene and close. Now we need to open our area 2D script and order that. When the player enters the area, the from level variable of the global scene will save the name of the parent node of the area 2D, like level 1, central, etc. Finally, let's add a script to level 1 that we will call levels. And let's order that. When the scene is ready, if global from level is different from null, check the player node and send it to the position that has the same name that is saved in from level plus the suffix pulse. As an example, level 1 plus pulse. Now we have to go to central and load the levels.gd script and we can already test.
Okay, now all you need to do is repeat the same process for all other map entries using an area 2D and a position 2D.
We can click on area 2D level 1 and duplicate it. Then just position it and then, in the Transform tab, we can rotate it 90 degrees. Then we need to create position to the level 2 pulse and repeat the same process for the other entries. Now just open the other levels. Repeat the same thing you did in level 1. And don't forget to load the script levels.gd in each level. Well, I hope this video can help you with your project. If you can give me your feedback in the comments, it will be very valuable to me. See you in the next video, and may the code be with you.